and you get something in there to pry it, it will just come out. You don't want to be too hard on it because, of course, you could break it. So, and of course, if you break it, then you're shit out of luck. So there we go. That pops. Come on, don't make an asshole out of me. I think I'm making an asshole out of myself. Uh-oh, don't break. Oh my God, don't break. You little bugger. You click back in. So anyways, yeah, when you're done screwing around, you get it free. You take your spring, put that aside. You have your little mount. I don't think we need to wash that because it's internal. We do need to wash the trigger, though. And as I say, there's this magnet here that looks like it would be a bit of a pain in the ass to get out of there, but I think I'm going to try to do it anyway because I'm feeling adventurous that way. Let me go ahead and go into my toolbox and try to find something to push that out. Okay, now to get this little button of whatever the hell this is, it is a magnet because as we can see, it's grabbing a hold of my little tiny screwdriver here. Now these little guys, you'll have to get yourself something that can fit in that little hole there. And if you push it just enough, it'll pop out. No big deal. All right, put that aside. And then this is ready to wash. Bang. And we get the other one. And I think I'll do that off camera so that we can move this thing along. So just as a final check, you want to make sure before you send things off to wash, sorry for the noise in the background, before you send things off to wash, make sure there's no metal in here because of course the last thing you want to do is get everything wet, reassemble everything partially wet, and then it all rusts up and goes to hell in a handbasket. So I got no metal in here, I'm good to go to wash. All right, so I'm back from wash, I don't need my gloves anymore. But you'll have it all wet like that, and just be sure to have another towel on hand that you've set up to lay these guys on. You know, give it a good whack there to get all that that water off there if you are washing the parts like I am. And one thing, before you even think of putting this fucking controller in a tub or a sink, make sure that you cover the drain and let it fill a little bit. And you must watch for this tiny, tiny, tiny little piece here, because if you lose this, you will scream and you will hate yourself and you will wonder how you ever had your head screwed on straight. So just don't lose that, because that goes, I'm gonna be back in a second. I have to dry everything and then I'll show you how this goes back together. Okay, so now we've got everything back from washing and we're ready to reassemble. Just one thing to note, you wanna make sure that these are dry. I have banged these onto cloth, banged it like that to get all the water out. Water loves to hide in the crevices of these things, so you gotta kind of bang them on that just to make sure that the water comes out. Again, do not lose this little son of a, because it fits in here like so. And if you lose that, well, don't blame me. We're going to get into reassembly now. Just as an aside real quick, if you guys are wondering what the hell to use to clean the plastic parts, you can use whatever the hell you want. Just don't use anything too harsh. I'd say, if you're not going to use it on your body, don't use it on this because it'll probably discolor the plastic or something. You can get these little brushes, nail brushes at the dollar store. They help to get in there and brush off all the crap. You can also use a kitchen sponge. So there you have it. Use shampoo, use dish detergent, whatever you want to use. So let's get back into reassembly. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to locate our buttons in the appropriate place. I have no idea where they go. Okay, just to save you the tedium of having watch me clusterfuck this all, you put the buttons where they go, you put the covers where they go, of course, carbon side down so that they, or whatever the hell that coating is, so that they can do their magic once you plug it into your lovely little Dreamcast, if I can speak English. And we're off to the races. So now we gotta get our board, we gotta get our wires, which we've cleaned as well. Just run it over with a rag and some gentle cleaner of some sort. And I'm gonna get part of this together and I'm gonna try to go step by step, but I've only got so much time. For the sake of making my life easier, I think we're just gonna go in real time from here. If I have to split it up into a second video, I guess that's what we're gonna do. Because of course those playing at home are gonna have a hell of a time putting this back together. I mean, I'm assuming it's pretty much common sense, the reverse of assembly, but Every now and again, somebody will get caught up in something and wonder what the hell happened. So, for the sake of argument, let's just do it together. You want to get our springs ready in our little trigger cradle thingies. I don't know what the hell you call these. And of course, they are directional. All right, so we got to locate the. That doesn't go on that one. All right, that's got it. So, we got to just put it back in place. It will snap into place, of course, and just make do a function check, make sure the trigger works, and just go ahead and do the other one really quick because people are sitting there going, why the hell am I watching a guy put together a Dreamcast controller? I could be doing something exciting now. There you go, function check that one. Make sure if you've taken out your magnets that you put them back in. Those are ready to go. Where am I? I'm lost. My God. This is the most horrible, horrible how to sort of not do things video ever. Oh, okay. Now this is a tricky one because you got to get it right because it only goes on a couple of ways. And I think that's it. And
Now,
of
of course,
course, I've
it.
completely forgotten and neglected to put back my lovely Dreamcast thingy-majiggy. I don't even know what you would call this thing. It just kind of swings into place just like that, clipped in the faceplate, I guess you could call it. And
Upside down.
there we go. Okay, this kind of goes in there. All right, so that one went in nice. So there we go for those playing along at home. Okay, so don't forget to pop your screws in. Otherwise, I don't know what happens. Maybe it pops out while you're in the middle of
So just
a
make
game
sure
of
that
Street
you
Fighter or something. Double check that everything works before you go ahead and reassemble everything, that your triggers work, and that you have put the screws in, okay, to hold that in place. Otherwise, you're going to be cursing like I have been for the last 5 minutes. And you make sure that your buttons are flat because you don't want to get this halfway together and then notice you have a button that's squished. Okay, so then turn it over, hold it, and do a quick button check. Make sure that everything works before you go into final assembly. And then you get your wire. Gonna go ahead and plug that. And remember that the tabs on top are gonna slide in. That sounds dirty, but take it from me, it's not dirty. Plug it in like that. Be real gentle because those wires can be kind of sensitive. So we have to don't forget to screw in your thumbstick, okay? Because it's kind of
So
important.
we have to take this very carefully, pop it in the back here, which is hiding like the little bastard that it is.
Okay, and tighten that up. Get the other screw. It's just too hard to get in there with your fingers and start dinking around with it. So get some pliers, get some, I got needle nose here, these little guys, or you can use tweezers if you don't
Yeah,
have
that's
any of
in like
those.
that.
Take our backing and again, function check, everything's good. And then we go ahead with final assembly.
Okay, and there we have it. So we're back together and we're clean and there's no schmutz everywhere. You know, you gotta watch in here when you go to clean these because it's always gonna have some kind of crap in there, like chocolate or some kind of snots or something. That some kid had on his, you know, he's sitting there playing Street Fighter and wipes his nose and blah, and puts it on there and it's stuck in the groove there. And of course, nobody cleans their controllers, so it's disgusting when you buy a used one. And now it's like a bought one, as Dave Jones on the EEV blog would say. So, I hope you've enjoyed my teardown and rebuild and cleaning of the Sega Dreamcast controller. Thank you so much for watching.